Okay, I had a really like a quick evolution video to get on with here. It was back to the diet. I'm talking about, okay, back from the trees, we're out of the trees, we're little tiny things, and then we start to become bigger and more defined in our facials year after year after year. We change, you know, we're changing. Just like the dog breeds, you know, they takes just a few years, and you can alter the shape of a dog, or you can alter his characteristics, all kinds of things, even personalities. So, same things are happening with us quite quickly. When all of this is, and that's a define that we're making along the way. That's not necessarily that we're breeding with another tribe over there. It's not that we're selecting that way necessarily. We are actually making those definitions. Like, I really like this particular look, and we don't like that particular look. So all of this is going on. We're making these choices, you know. So we're being selective and showing favoritism all along the way. And you can see that with the entire animal kingdom. You can see that with all of the ducks. You can see that all of the monkeys, all of the animals. They've selected themselves to be as fine and wonderful as they are. You know, that's how the monkey has just that white eyebrows, because it's just been refined through the years. The chances are, if you take that monkey back and go 100,000 years ago, their eyebrows were not as refined. They were maybe partly, you know, maybe hints of, and they were like, oh, that's cool. And so somehow along the way, those ones were given more leniency to reproduce. So at the definition point, though, we're getting back to this fallout of the diet. I'm going to call it the fallout diet. We're evolving from a fallout that's been given to us, and it's been given to us based upon what we are capable of doing. All of this food creation is just only we eat because we're capable of creating it, putting it in front of us, having it on a platter. That's why we eat it. It's not necessarily because through the years of evolution that's the right way to go, that's the right evolution to take, that's the right handful of food. It does not necessarily mean that. It just means that was the easy way that brought us to evolve further. You know, so in essence, the populations themselves increase not necessarily because of good, but because of easy. You understand? It's easy to eat all white bread. It's cheap. Thusly, you can have populations increase. You know, they're all fed. However, in this particular time frame, that's not good for them. So they're evolving, but they're evolving where it's not good for them, but they are able to produce, you see. So this is where we're coming from. Okay, we had this meat introduction way back there 2 million years ago, 3 million years ago, big meat introduction. Brought in, you know, from raw, starting into fire. No, I don't believe we were packing fire around like the Olympiads. I don't believe any of that was going on. I don't think we were killing and then dragging it into a steam pit. I don't think that was going on either. I think it was random when fires did happen. And chances are it was helped and exasperated with a forest fire. You've given them a boost, but I don't believe they just walked out of the trees and started, you know, hitting to make the fire, but hey, wait, they did in essence start the stones, they started the flint, they started the cutting of stones for tools, and in that process they could have had sparks happen. Okay, only then, out of hey, look, you know, this is working. But for a long time that wouldn't have gone on. They were still without fire. Okay, so here we are with the carnivore diet. You know, they're going out hunting. They're getting mammoths. You know? Okay, they start to bring in more meat after this fire event. They're bringing in more and more meat. Okay, that doesn't necessarily mean it was a good thing for the body. It just means that was easy. Once they had made the tools, once they had made the spears, where was it that I was reading the fight with the spears? One group was with the spears and one group was with the hatchets. And that went on between different types of these hominid groups. Hatchets or spears, you know, big difference, you know, for a lot of years. That was just what they made. So it happens, one group was just hatchets and the other was just the spears. That was very interesting to me, actually, because eventually, you know, man, we become hatchets and spears. But so here they are, they're out there with their hatchet and attacking or whatever. And so that was their first weapon to use, you know, for one major group was just the hatchets. And you can go back to like the Mohicans, a lot of the Indians, they were always using these hatchets, and they did not use spears. So that actually comes down very recently, that activity of just having that one major weapon as your stronghold. Okay, but just because they were capable does not necessarily mean it was correct. So that's what we're really dealing with, is the capability factor versus what's actually good for you. And we are the fallout, you know, this particular time, we are the fallout of all of their capabilities. You know, they were capable to run and chase and get a big mammoth. They were capable of going after large yaks or whatever, or wildebeest. They were capable of taking buffalo. They were capable, and it brought them food easy. They hung it to dry it, and then, well, they didn't have to gather as much. They just didn't have to gather as much, and so when all of this extra capability comes along, that's all we are, is we're just the fallout of it. And it does not mean anything aside from our human nature is just predisposed to be, hey, I've done the hunt, I want to be lazy now, and just hang around. So we are pretty much coming from a lazy batch. So, that's what's going on. You know, they have that Olympic moment, you know, that they show every 4 years. Everybody runs through and does the race real fast. Then they just want to be the lazy couch potato after. Much, much duration on that laze self. You know, run and chase and then laze. So whether it's anything you do, your work effort, you know, you're going doing your... you have to drive here, you have to drive there, you have to do that errand, or you have to go to this particular school, you have to see these people, or all of this for work, or whatever. And that is like your man hunter self heading out there and doing all those things. And then back to the lays of the homestead, where you just are just planked out and you don't have to do anything. So that's really what we brought down. Now, is that truly, you know, our correct exercise self? That's another question. You know, is that really our true exercise self? You know, the all or nothing? I really believe that that is that's the wrong way to go, the wrong approach. I believe we are supposed to be more even, you know, a more even self rather than the sprinter. And then back to this couch potato or this nothing activity. And obviously cars have not helped anything because the cars themselves are they're not horses. You don't even have to get hoist up on them. You don't have to do much at all. You just sit in there. And they are not helping our exercise factor. They're not helping. We don't have any hoist up on a horse muscles left. I don't believe any of us do, unless you really go out there and practice riding. So, yeah. So we've really come away from regular this new, you know, the hunter. Once the gatherer has brought the hunter in to the society. We have really lost that mingle of exercise during the day. You know what I'm saying? The mingle where you know, you have your endurance moment and then you don't, and then your endurance moment and then you don't. Or I'm just going to get up and I'm going to go garden, or I'm just going to rest for like 5 minutes and then I'm going to get up and I'll go out and do something out that direction, or, and then rest for another little bit. All of this type would be more conducive, it would be closer to the way an ape would work. But most of the ape family, they just, you know, aren't going to just go run, jog, and then snooze for hours on end. They're not that way. They would be more even keeled, I guess they call it. Even keeled is in sailor talk. They would be out there able to gather, eat a little bit, gather some more, eat a little bit, and gather some more, and then sleep or whatever. And then here you are doing that. Remember, our bodies, our insides, our internals have been doing that activity for 35 million years before, you know, we left those trees. So our endurance factor has really been pushed to be these sprint heavy go, and then stop, you know, go and then stop, you know. And it's even now cycled into the work cycle. You know, you work after your college or whatever, you're 20 years old, and then you head out to you work till when you're 65, they say, and then, yeah, then basta pasta, you know, you retire. We're 67 now, you retire. So yeah, it's been worked in. So race, and then stop. And it just doesn't seem like it's a fair system to the body, does it? It just does not seem fair. Doesn't seem like it's giving us that all day energy cycle. Looks like we're interrupted. Looks like we're just like prongs, like a cattle. What do you call the cattle prod? We're being cattle prodded into action, and then stop. You know. So it does seem like we've headed ourselves unbalanced. We're the fallout evolution, and we're not the fall in. We're not getting it we're not getting the evolution as a brainstorm increase enough. You know, we have to head in that brainstorm increase, so we are not just the degrade moment of a giant population that was capable to hunt because they learned how and because they fashioned those weapons. I don't know. I guess that's where I'm thinking about how we are falling from from there, based upon not smarts, although they try to keep saying that we were so smart to invent fire or so smart, but I don't believe our fall out from there was from smart. I think it was just from what we were capable of doing, and that's different. It's much more different. It doesn't take wise, it doesn't take witty, it didn't need any of that. It just needed, you know, I can do this. You know, that's all. That's where we come from. I can do this. And it's not clever. Not a clever person. Okay. Yeah, and then stop.